We're going to start talking about division. Remember how subtraction was the reverse process of addition? Well, division is going to be the reverse process of multiplication. So undoing multiplication is what division is how you can think of it. For whole numbers, we said how in multiplication it's repeated addition. So for whole numbers, division would be repeated subtraction, because subtraction undoes addition. So we're going to focus not just on whole numbers, but we're also going to focus on decimal numbers, polynomials, fractions or rational numbers, rational expressions, radicals, and complex numbers. So division is going to be a binary operation, which is this bar with two dots. That's the symbol we use for division. And the way it's defined is for any three mathematical objects, A, B, and C, where B is not zero, A divided by B, that's how you read this. A divided by B is equal to C if and only if A is the product of B and C. Again, A divided by B is C if and only if the product of B and C gives you A. So in this notation, A divided by B equaling C, A is called the dividend. B is called the divisor, and the result of this division is called the quotient. So again, A is called the dividend, B is called the divisor, and C is called the quotient. We say that B divides A completely if and only if B is a factor of A. So for example, 2 divides 6 because 2 is a factor of 6. We can write 6 as 2 times 3. Another way to say that would be 6 divided by 2 is 3. So another way to represent A divided by B is A over B. In the 1800s, they also have shown how people used to use the little slash, which also means A divided by B. So there are many different notations that have existed before this division sign. It might be worth your while to go look at the history of division. Remember, like we said before, the notation that we currently use for arithmetic symbols is not that old. In the olden days, really olden days, like thousands of years ago, people used to write A with no bar, but B under it without the bar to represent fractions. So when we were looking at multiplication, we looked at 6 as 2 times 3, 2 rows of 3 objects, or 3 rows of 2 objects. So there are two ways of interpreting division. We have 6 divided by 2. One interpretation is 2 times what gives you 6? Or how many in each group if you wanted 2 groups? So you want 2 groups, how many in each group if you wanted 6 objects? So that's like saying you want 2 rows of objects for a total of 6 objects. How many objects in each row? So here's 1 row, 2 rows. Each had 3 objects in it, so the answer would be 3. 3 objects in each group. So this is the how many in each group interpretation. Take a look at if I had something times 2 equaling 6. That would be how many groups. So we're saying put 2 objects in each group. How many groups would you get? So how many rows would you get? Another way of saying that. So if I put 2 objects, I 1, 2. You just start putting 2 at a time, 2 at a time, until you exhaust 6. And you can see the answer is 3. So two different interpretations of division. All right, so seeing the two different interpretations is important. Let's take a look. Suppose we told you you have 12 marbles and you want to equally distribute it amongst 3 people. So you have 3 groups. And you want to know how many in each group, how many marbles can each person get. So here are my 12 marbles. Here's my buckets for 3 people. I want to give everybody the 12 marbles equally. So we're going to have to do what? Start distributing the marbles. So we'll go one person, second person, third person. So these 3 marbles were given 1 for each person. You do that across all of them until you exhaust them. And so looks like everybody got 4 marbles. So 12 divided by 3 would be 4, since 12 is 4 times 3. We have 3 people and everybody got 4 marbles. What if we have 12 marbles and each person has to have 3 marbles? Then what? So now we're going to give 3 marbles at a time. So we don't know how many people, so let's just have a whole bunch of buckets and see what happens. So let's put 3 at a time. So let's put everybody gets 3. So you have to distribute it in groups of 3s. So the number of things in one group is 3. You want to know how many groups. And you can see how we don't need that extra bucket because we've already exhausted all the 12 marbles. So we needed 4 groups. 3 marbles per person, 4 people can get it. So again, 12 divided by 3 is 4, but the interpretation is very different. Remember, before, what did you have? You had 3 buckets and you put 4 marbles in each. Now you have 4 buckets and you're putting 3 marbles in each. So even though the answer is the same, the interpretation is very different. All right, let's take a look at another problem. Suppose you have 5 marbles and you wanted to share them equally amongst 3 friends. Then what? So here are my 3 friends and here's my marbles. So you'll have to go one at a time. And that's it because these 2 marbles cannot be split. So each friend is only going to get 1 marble and then there are 2 left over. Sometimes when people write 5 divided by 3 is 1 whole, remainder is 2. That's how you read that. So 1 is the quotient and remainder is 2. 5 is the dividend, 3 is the divisor, 1 is the quotient, and 2 is the remainder. And division algorithm states that we can write 5 then as what? 1 times 3, right? 3 people, everybody got 1 marble, plus the 2 extra, that makes up the total 5. If this 2 was a 0, then that would mean 3 divides 5 evenly. So sometimes division problems will leave you a remainder. They don't perfectly divide the numbers. But even the remainder can take very different forms. So let's keep going. Suppose we have 5 chocolates and 3 friends, and we want to give chocolates equally now instead of marbles. So here's my 5 chocolates instead of 5 marbles. And what do? Again, we'll give each of the friends 1 chocolate. Then what? What do you do with the remaining 2 chocolates? Well, since it's a food item, we can split it. So we'll break each one into thirds. And so let's give everybody 2/3. Can you see that? Look again. So each person can get 1/3, 1/3, 1/3. Same thing from here, 1/3, 1/3, 1/3. So everybody can get 2 pieces of those, right? Because we have 3 friends. So the answer here would be what? Each friend got 1 2/3 of a chocolate, or 5 divided by 3 is 5 over 3, or 1 whole plus 2/3. So 5 over 3 is the same as 1 whole and 2/3. Okay, well, now what if you have $5 you want to share equally amongst 3 friends? All right, so clearly we're going to give everybody $1. Well, we can rip a dollar into thirds. However, we can exchange it. What can we exchange it for? We can exchange it for quarters. So now we can give each person what? 2 quarters. All right, so let's give everybody 2 quarters. So now everybody has $1.50. Well, we can't really break this quarters into anything, so but we can exchange it. We can exchange the quarters for what? Good. We can exchange it for dimes. So 2 quarters will become 5 dimes. Okay, so now we can give everybody 1 dime. These 2 dimes we'll have to exchange and make what? Nickels out of them. And then give everybody a nickel. And now we have a nickel, so we'll have to exchange that for pennies. Give everybody a penny, and there will be 2 pennies left. So another way to say that would be everybody got $1.66 because money can't be divided into any smaller units than a penny, so it would just be $1.66 with 2 pennies left over. But if it were decimal numbers, then what? Then you can say 1.6 repeating. So it'll just be 6666 You'll just have to keep doing that over and over again. So that'll be 1.6 bar in decimal form. We'll see more of decimal number division later. When we are given the following information, that Alex's exam scores are these four numbers here, respectively, then what's the average score on his exam? So how do you compute average? Most of you know that you take the sum of all the four scores and divide by the number of exams. So add up all the total, which is 320, and divide it by 4. You already know how to reduce fractions. You can reduce the 4s, and that'll give you 80. So another interpretation is that when you find the average, what you're really doing is you're redistributing the scores so that they're all 80. All right, so here's another way to compute average then. Take all the four scores, and let's see. We want everybody to have the same score. So 87 is the highest. So let's just make that an 80 and borrow 7. So we're going to borrow the 7 and redistribute to see if they become equal. So we'll make that an 80, take the 7, and then, let's see, to make that an 80, we'll have to go 2 there and 5 there. So if you split the 7 as 5 and 2 and leave the 5 with this one and get the 2 this one, then all four scores are 80. So the average is 80. All right, in general then, an answer to a division of two whole numbers can be many different forms depending on the context. We can extend the concept of division to all the objects we've studied in Module 1. And then here are some examples. So 5 divided by 3 or 5/3, this polynomial divide by this polynomial, which will be the quotient that we've been working with, rational expressions. If you have two functions, f and g, then f of x over g of x will give you this division, and you just have to make sure that the function g of x is not 0. Can't have 0 in the denominator. If you have two radical expressions divided each other, then you're going to have this quotient to work with, which we've done before. So in some sense, you've already been working with division when you were working with fractions. So a lot of the division stuff you've already learned. But now we're looking at division in a different way.